Hey, what's up, YouTube? This is Sarah. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about how to close a smart asset lead. And if you stick around until the end, I'm going to give you some online prospecting strategies so that you can find qualified individuals for your financial advisor practice. So the first thing you have to understand when you're trying to close a lead from SmartAsset or any of these other lead generation services for financial advisors is that the online buyer, someone that comes to you through the internet, has very different motivations and expectations than somebody that is referred to you or that you meet in person. And there are a few reasons for that. First of all, think about why somebody looks online for a financial advisor. Either they don't have any qualified advisors that they like in their circle, or they have some kind of a special circumstance where what's available to them just isn't able to meet the requirements. Let's say, for example, I had a special needs child. Maybe the advisors I know in my circle don't specialize in this, or don't know the laws, or don't know the investment products that are available, or the estate planning moves that need to be made for a special needs child, etc. So in that case, you would resort to the internet because you also wouldn't, you know, it's an easy way to find information at least about this, and you also don't have to go running around to your friends and talking about the fact that you have a special needs child that you need to provide financial stability for, right? It's kind of awkward. So people don't always like to go to their networks to look for financial advisors because sometimes people don't want other people knowing how much money they have. Because it naturally begs the question, oh, you're looking for a financial advisor. What, right, like how many, what's your assets? Like what's, you know what I'm saying? So understand that they go to the internet for a very specific reason, and that is to look for information. They're not looking for a relationship right away. And this is what most financial advisors get wrong about when they get a lead from SmartAsset or any of these other lead generation services. They think right away that they're gonna close it like you would close a referral from a client. This is a warm relationship. Online buyer is cold. Don't confuse those two things. So as a result, your approach is entirely different. Because they're looking for information, not to be best friends, they're not looking to lock in right away, you offer them information, but you don't barf on them. No barfing. You can't dump every piece of information about your company and what you do and let's buy some whole life insurance, folks. You're gonna come off like every single other advisor in the world. It's the tired old cliche of the financial advisor at the Chamber of Commerce meeting that's handing out the business card and trying to get everybody to be his or her client. It's like, come on, have we seen this before? They have. And so if you do that, you're going to trigger a negative pattern in someone's mind. They already have seen these financial advisor behaviors. That's what they're rejecting. That's where they're going to the internet. Don't fall into the trap. What you would do is create a set of questions, not too probing, but just try to find out when the lead contacts you, what kind of information they're looking for. You should also prepare an introductory set of materials, such as an introduction video or an introduction newsletter, something that's just very warm, lots of warmth, positive energy, and willingness to offer information, but don't barf, like I said. I can tell you a little bit more about this. If you join my membership, just click below. I have videos about this, and you'll also be on a members webinar, private webinar every month where we discuss these techniques. So, the other thing that I just wanted to mention before I end the video is the high net worth prospecting technique that I told you about in the beginning. What I would do is, if you were looking for clients on the internet, I would create some kind of a takeaway that people can come to you for, and then I would optimize either a video or a blog with that keyword. So for example, planning for a special needs, financial planning for a child with special needs. Create a worksheet, give that the title of it, but we can title the worksheet that way, make that the title of a blog or YouTube video, and then SEO optimize it. This is especially critical if you have a low following, meaning less than 5,000 followers on either YouTube or LinkedIn. And this will attract people, but Just remember, when they come to you and they ask you for that lead magnet piece, don't barf. Give them the information tactfully and carefully over time. Provide them with more information to position yourself as an expert, but not a barfer. Thank you everybody for watching. Like I said, I will hope to see you in my membership, where I cover online networking and prospecting strategies for financial advisors. Click the link below, and it's the blue button at the top. See you next video.